sing the praises to our King, for he is the King of Kings. We sing the praises to our King, for he's the King of Kings. Give him glory, for he is the King. Give him glory, for he's the King of Kings. Happy Sabbath, boys and girls. I hope you all are happy to be here. It's Children's Church. I'd just like to welcome everybody to Children's Church. And as always, this program will be, there's going to be a lot of praises to our King. There's going to be scriptures from the Bible and lessons to be learned so that we can use them in our everyday lives. Before we begin with the program, though, I'm going to say a word of prayer. So close your eyes, bow your heads, and fold your hands for prayer. We want to thank you this day that you've given us, Lord. Bless us and guide us. Thank you for keeping us throughout the week. Thank you for giving us life to be able to come here and worship you today. Help us listen and pay attention to what will be said in today's program. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. So without further ado, I'll see you guys later. Bye.
With one another in love. Hello, boys and girls. It is time to join with us as we sing. We're going to sing some choruses, and I know that you know them, so don't sit there and keep quiet. Stand up wherever you are and sing with us. We are going to start with "What a Mighty God We Serve." And today, Sister Lyle is with me. So we are ready to sing. And so we're expecting you to shout and sing and give praises to God. Are you ready? All right, let's do this. What a mighty God we serve, then. He's a miracle-working God. And we know that he's able. He's able to see you through. He's able to do anything you want him to do as long as it's in his will. So God is mighty. 2, 3.
What a mighty God we serve. Oh, what a mighty God we serve.
Angels bow
before him. Heaven and earth adore him. What a mighty God we serve. What a mighty God we serve. Oh, what a mighty God we serve.
Angels bow
before him. Heaven and earth adore him. What a mighty God we serve. I command you, Satan, in the name of the Lord, to throw down your weapons and flee. For the Lord has given me authority to walk all over thee. What a mighty God we serve. Oh, God we serve.
Angels bow
before him. Heaven and earth adore him. What a mighty God we serve. He's a miracle-working God. He's a miracle-working God. My God is a wonder. My God is a miracle. He's a miracle-working God.
One more time.
He's a miracle-working God. He's a miracle-working God. My God is a wonder. My God is a miracle. He's a miracle-working God. He's able, I know he's able. I know my Lord is able to carry me through.
Oh yes,
he's able, I know he's able. I know my Lord is able to carry me through.
He healed the brokenhearted and set the captives free. He made the lame to walk again and caused the blind to see. I know he's able, he's able. I know he's able. I know my Lord is able to carry me through.
One more time. He's able, he's able. I know he's able. I know my Lord is able to carry me through. He's able, he's able. I know he's able. I know my Lord is able to carry me through. He heals the brokenhearted and set the captives free. He made the lame to walk again and caused the blind to see. I know he's able, he's able. I know he's able. I know my Lord is able to carry me through.
Amen.
Happy Sabbath, boys and girls. How are you all doing? I pray you all have a great week. Let's ask Jesus to come into our hearts as we pray. Dear Jesus, thank you for this, your holy Sabbath day. Thank you for all your wonderful boys and girls. Help us to be more like you. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Boys and girls, we don't have to worry about knowing what God wants us to do. He has told us in His law and He will never change His mind. His law shows us how much He loves us. My friend Ellen wrote, "The law of God from its very nature is unchangeable. It is a revelation of the will and the character of its author." The Great Controversy, page 467. Boys and girls, have you ever noticed how many signs there are beside the road? I wonder why are there so many traffic signs? After all, only a foolish person would head down the street on the wrong side, drive really fast in a school zone, or go through a dangerous crossroads without stopping. Signs aren't just for foolish people. Do you think so? I guess not. Sometimes normal, safe drivers make mistakes and aren't as careful as they should be. The highway department put these signs up to remind everyone how to stay safe and arrive home all in one piece. The signs aren't just for people who break laws. They help law keepers know what to do so they can drive better and safer. That's exactly what God's laws do as well. God's laws? Yes! God's laws, the Ten Commandments, help us to know wrong from right. The Ten Commandments teach us how to live when the devil tries to confuse us with lies and false promises. Boys and girls, just think of the Ten Commandments as signs along the road of life. Now, boys and girls, whenever you watch for traffic signs from the car, you should smile, because as law keepers. We should be glad that they're there helping us stay safe until we all get to heaven. Dear Jesus, thank you for giving us your law. We feel much safer knowing what to do and what not to do. Help us to be more like you. Guide our hearts and minds from the things of this world so that we can focus upon you. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Goodbye, boys and girls. See you next time. God bless and keep you all.
Unto the hills, from whence cometh my help. My help cometh from the Lord, which made heaven and earth. He will not suffer thy foot to be moved. He that keepeth thee will not slumber. Behold, he that keepeth Israel shall neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord is thy keeper. The Lord is thy shade upon thy right hand. The right hand shall not smite thee by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord shall preserve thee from all evil. He shall preserve thy going and thy coming in from this time forth and even for evermore.
So, quarantine. We all know it has been here for a while, and in case it doesn't end as soon as we'd hope, here are some tips to keep you going. Number one is to make a routine. Wake up from bed and just think in your mind, what are you gonna do today for productivity, your work, school, your fun? And organizing activities just helps so much and helps relieve some stress. Number two is to get some air. We're not allowed to go outside now, but we can still go and you find a space or maybe the backyard to do some stretches or some exercises, maybe a little jog. It really helps mentally too. Number three is to eat healthy. We're all at home, you know, we have no excuses to just take our time to prepare a nice, decent meal. And so that also helps, you know, eating good meals that while you're at home, it helps. Thank you, everyone. I hope you have a great day.
Boys and girls, I want you to imagine a bunch of candles in front of you. Some can be short, some can be tall, some can be skinny, and some can be fat. Did you know that boys and girls are like candles? Each one of you looks good. You're already very pretty or very handsome, but when Jesus comes into your life, you just light up. Jesus and his love will help you to shine brightly, and you will act and look better. With Jesus in your life, you will be happier, you will have a smile on your face, and you will not want to be disagreeable with your brothers and sisters, your friends, or your parents. Your time in Sabbath school and church will be happy. A candle is just a little candle until someone lights it. A boy or girl is just a child until Jesus fills him or her with his love. That is the birth of Jesus in you. Jesus said, "You are the light of the world." Are you ready for Jesus to make you like a bright, shining birthday candle? So boys and girls, take your candle. Go light the world, make your mark, and shine. Shine for Jesus. Whatever you do, wherever you go, shine. Thank you for listening to this life lesson. I hope you learned a lot.
Hello, boys and girls. Today, I'll be singing a song. My name is Akiva, and the title of my song is "I Will See in Your Heart." The heart is a place of your storage of love. And now I'll be singing. Your heart is a place of love that gives you happiness and shows you the world how good, how sweet it is. I see the wind blow soft, the winds tearing up, and wonder of the moon shine brightly in the noon. Shine bright, I will see in your heart, and though our heart is not of beauty, it's a heart of me. Thank you for listening. Have a great day, and may God bless you.
Hello, boys and girls. Let's play a game. Can you guess what kind of pet I have? My pet likes to play even when I do not feel like playing. Sometimes he races around the house as if he is chasing something I can't see. He likes to take a nap in the bright sunshine by the window, and he eats and drinks from bowls on the kitchen floor. When he wants to go outside, he scratches on the door. Can you guess what kind of pet I have? Okay, one more clue. When I throw a stick, he chases it and brings it back to me. Did you guess? At first, I could have been describing either a dog or a cat, but cats do not chase sticks. You could tell my pet is a dog by the way he behaved, by the things he did. Being a Christian is like that too. You could tell who is following Jesus by the things they do and the things they don't do. Whoever says that he lives in God must live as Jesus lived. The Bible says in 1 John 2, verse 6. That means we should be kind and helpful and friendly, like Jesus was. Because Jesus was never selfish, we shouldn't be selfish either. We should think about others first just as he did. Because we love Jesus, we want to do only things that will make us more like him. What do you think makes a person beautiful? Sometimes people wear wild or strange clothes or jewelry just to get attention. But the Bible says, it is not the fancy hair, gold jewelry, or fine clothes that should make you beautiful. No, your beauty should come from within you, the beauty of a gentle and quiet spirit that will never be destroyed, and is very precious to God. 1 Peter 3, verse 3 and 4. Christians are careful about what they eat and drink because they want to take care of the body God has given them. Things like dangerous drugs, alcohol, and tobacco would make us unhealthy and keep us from hearing God's voice in our heart. We try to get plenty of exercise and eat lots of the wonderful fruit and vegetables God created. Christians love to have fun, but not the kind of fun that would hurt people or the kind that leads us away from Jesus. We want the things that make us laugh to be the kind of things that would make Jesus laugh too. We want whatever we watch or read or hear to make us more like Jesus. May God bless you as you live for Him.
Hi, boys and girls. I'm so happy again to see you and so that we can actually be together. Today's question is, Pastor Parker, why is it that God and our parents want us to have good Christian behavior? All right. that's a really nice question. All right. But let me try to explain. Christian behavior is a very good thing. We should all behave ourselves at school, behave ourselves at home, behave ourselves properly on the street, behave ourselves when we go on the plane, when we travel to different countries. We should live obedient lives, because someone once said to me that manners and respect can definitely carry you throughout the entire world, right? Or throughout life, because by being respectful and kind and very nice and gentle to people and courteous to people, it makes a difference in terms of the kind of relationship that we have with different individuals. The other thing about Christian behavior is that we are representatives of Christ. In other words, we are like ambassadors for Christ. Wherever we go, we represent Christ. Wherever we go, people should know that we are Christians, even as little boys and girls. Individuals must understand that the God that you serve is the one who creates the heaven and the earth, the one who is in charge, and that His Spirit and His power and His grace is flowing through your entire life. Amen, boys and girls. The other thing about when it comes down to Christian behavior is that we should do the right things in the sight of God and behave ourselves because of a deep sense of thankfulness and gratitude that we have in our hearts based on the goodness of God in our lives. The Bible says that the goodness of God lead thee to repentance, right? The goodness of God is the one that inspires our Christian behavior. The goodness of God is what motivates those of us who are Christians to do the right thing. Let me share a Bible text. In the book of Romans chapter 12, verses 1 and 2, this is what the Bible actually says about the whole understanding or what should be the foundation of Christian behavior. It says, I beseech you therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service, and be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind. Right? And so you can see there where the Bible is giving us several kind of understanding what the Christian life is all about, or Christian behavior is all about. God wants us to have a renewed mind, the mind that Jesus had. The Bible also says in Philippians 2 and verse 5, let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus our Lord. And so once we have the mind of Christ, and once we have gratitude, and once we have the proper understanding of what the Christian life is all about, that can influence us to do the right things as boys and girls wherever we go. Remember that when you do the right things, when you behave the right way, wherever you go, in your home, at school, wherever you are, always remember, we do the right things because we love Jesus and we are thankful to Him for all that He has blessed us with. Amen, boys and girls. God bless you and have a wonderful rest of the Sabbath. Amen.
Goodness, you know, every single week, it's almost like I watch Children's Church for the first time every single week because it's always so special to me. I hope you all were able to learn something from the program. I hope you guys listened to Pastor Parker as he was answering that question, and I hope you all learned a lot from this program. Before we go, though, I'd like to say a word of prayer. We want to thank you this day that you've given us, Lord. Thank you for the wonderful program you've given us. Thank you for helping us to be attentive. And thank you for giving us the ears to be able to listen and learn to what was learned today. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. Remember to send your suggestions to connecttochrist@gmail.com. Remember, connecttochrist@gmail.com. And any suggestions that may relate to Children's Church or anything you may like to see more and stuff like that. Until next time, I'll see you all later. Bye. Isn't he wonderful?